students. Now we are going to start the first lesson of class 2. The name of the lesson is Me and My Family. Yes, Me and My Family. Do you have family? I think all of you have family, is it? So, who is called your family? Whether your friend is also your family? No. They are not belong to your family. The family means all of them should be reside in a single house or anyhow they are related with you. Is it? They are called your family. Now, you may ask that there are some relatives also with whom you frequently meet. So, are they your family just like that? Your maternal uncle, your maternal aunt, like that. Yes, they are also your family, but they are your extended family. So, today we will talk about the me and my family. That means you and your family. Sometimes your extended families also will come. So, how many family members are in your family? Do you know? If you know, then prepare a list. Who are staying with you? That means your family member's name and the relationship with you. Are you able to do? First thing, I want to tell you one thing that the family is three kind. That means depending upon the number of family member, the family is divided into three types. One is small family. Which family should be considered as the small family? Small family means the parents along with one or two child is called the small family. Whenever the parents will live along with one or two child. Is it clear? So that one will be the small family. Next, the big family. Big family means the parents when they will reside with more than two children. That family is called big family. Is it clear? Next, the joint family. Joint family means when the parents, grandparents, uncles, aunts, their children, all of them will reside together. That family is called joint family. Is it clear? So family, that one is different kind of family. One is the small family. One more thing is there. Small family is also called the nuclear family. Is it clear? Small family is also called the nuclear family. And the big family is, this joint family is also one version of big family. Definitely joint family means the family member is more. So that one is also one kind of big family. Now the thing is there that in which kind of family is comfortable for us. Basically, for the case of small family, how many family members are there? Maximum 3 or 4, because parents 2 and either 1 or 2 children. So maximum 4. What about the big family? Its minimum family member should be 5. Is it? Maybe more than that. And for the case of joint family also, the family member should be more than, that means parents, grandparents, children's, that means children should be more than 2 also. So definitely these also should be more than 5 or 6. So whenever the number of family members are less, on that time each and everything will be distributed, they should be more in amount. Is it or not? So that is the main reason the nuclear family or the small family is a happy family. Yes. Which one is the happy family? The small family, because they are getting the comforts because of the less presence of the family member. If so many siblings you have, siblings means your brother sister. If so many siblings you have, then on that time what problem you have, you will face. Then on that time, whatever your parent has, that means these all things will be distributed among them. Your mother, maybe she is a housewife or she is going to office, whatever maybe, but she is looking into you. She is taking care of you. Is it? If instead of one or two students, if your family member, that means your siblings, will become 10, on that time, how is it possible? Is it? It is very difficult for her also. So that's why always the small family is a happy family. Its members can get more comforts for themselves, like good foods. Yes, because in our family, to livelihood, we need money. Daily we need money for different kind of food, different dress, for education, this for all purpose. So whenever source is one source of income, only either your mother or your father, your parents, any one of them or both of them. So on that time, it will be divided into the others, among the other siblings also. So that time, the quality of the food, the quality of the clothes, the quality of education also, this will be reduced. Yes, this will be reduced. So as a result of it, the family won't become happy. So always happy family means the small family. Is it clear? And whenever your family will become small on that time, you will get the better education. Is it? And care also. All the things you will get more. For the case of the big family, members of a big family face more difficulties. A big family is not as happy as a small family. The children in it cannot get as good education. Yes, you know that how much expenditure is there for one student. If in your house 10 family members, that means 10 siblings are there, then is it possible to give them good education? I don't think so. So big family is not a happy family, as well as it is a unhealthy family also. Next, about the joint family. Joint family is little bit different, because joint family does not mean only the number of children will be increased. On that time, the number of earner is also increasing, because who is earning money? The parents, your uncles are also residing, your aunts are also residing. So on that time, the earning of the money should not be problem, because your earner are increasing. So that's why the good food quality, good education, that should not be a problem. But for that time also, they should face some problem. Which kind of problem? The adjustment problem. This happens also. So that one is also one kind of problem. And in this kind of family, the work is becoming more, because whenever family member is increasing, the work is also increasing. So on that time, what is our duty? Our duty is to share the works along the family member. So suppose you are doing, your parents, they are doing one work, your uncle or your aunt, they have to do another work. In this way, they have to do the works. They have to cooperative with each other. And you also have to be very careful. You have to do your work. What work you have to do? You have to complete your homework daily. That one is your very big work. Yes. Otherwise, your parent, they will be depressed because of you. Day by day, if you won't complete your homework, then that one will be very problematic, very tension for them. That one will give very tension for them. Is it? And one more thing you have to do. Whenever you will take any one of the object or any one of the thing from your home, after using that thing, you should place it into that position only. Yes, into the its own place. Suppose you took one book for reading. It's okay. You read. How much time do you want to read? After reading the book, you have to place the book in the same place. Is it clear? You took the one dress. After wearing, after whatever you have to do, after doing, you have to put it into the same place. This one is your duty. Otherwise, there should be adjustment problem. Yes, one person, how much work will they do? Is it possible to do only one, all the work by the one person? It is not possible also. And one more thing is there, for the case of joint family, they are giving the importance of the relationships. If you belong to the joint family, on that time, you may feel, I think, you may feel that the different enjoyments are there along with your grandmother, along with your grandfather, isn't? So, this kind of, they are telling us different stories. They are giving us a different kind of experience. They share the different kind of experience, what they did they face in their life, and they assist us also. And one more thing, you should never raise any kind of question on them, because whenever you will raise any question on them, on that time they will get hurt. Yes, they will get hurt, and you should not do them. That one you should not. So always, whatever they will say, you should obey them. You should not raise any kind of question. You should not hurt them in any way. Not only your grandmother, grandfather, to your parents also. You should be respectful with them, and you should be careful for them. And definitely they are also caring about you. When you was the small child, when you the newly born baby, on that time you was not able to do any work of you. On that time they did whatever work you have to do, all the works they did. So definitely you have to look care of their needs, their wishes, their happiness. You have to look care of this all, and in this way, your family will become a happy family.